What's going on, everyone? Stanley James here. In today's lesson, we're going to go through double drops. Now, if you're not aware what a double drop is, it is a technique used across a massive range of genres, but primarily used in things like drum and bass, bass house, house music. Now, it's really a way to just add another level of creativity to your sets as a DJ. So essentially what you're doing is layering two tracks on top of each other. Sounds pretty simple. But there's a lot of things that you need to think about when it comes to doing double drops. So why would you want to use this technique? Well, there's two things that you need to think about. One is going to really make you stand out as a DJ by coming up with something brand new and creative that no one else has thought of. It's something completely unique to you. Another thing is it's really going to catch the crowd off guard. So if you're just playing a set and you're going from tune to tune, that's all well and good. There's many DJs that do that and are great at doing that. But if you want to do something that just steps it up, catches the crowd off guard and makes them think, wow, that DJ has really stood out for me. You know, they might go home later and think, oh, wow, do you remember when the DJ did this double drop where he put these two tracks together? It's more likely to be remembered by the person who is in the crowd that night when the DJ does something amazing, right? So you just need to think about some, it's a great thing to be able to do when you're out performing. So there's a few things that I'm going to cover today. One of them is finding the right tracks and what will work. And then another thing we're going to go over is the importance of phrasing. So if you've seen previous lessons, you'll know about mixing in phrase and the importance of doing that. I'm just going to go through that again and show why it's so important within this technique. So tip number one, how do you find the right tracks that work well together? Well, to be totally honest, there's no right or wrong way to do this. Now, it's really down to experimenting, trial and error, what you think might work, and just giving it a go, basically. You might be out and about one day and you'll think, oh, that song's really good. That might work with this song, or this song might work with that song, and so on, so on. But you might get home, try it, and it might not work. So like I say, it's all down to just practicing, having fun with it, and just trying it out. So for this first example, I'm gonna go through one that I've been doing for a few years. It's just one that I saved, that I was at home one day mixing, came across these two tunes and fit them together and they worked really, really well. So it's just something that I've kept in my drum and bass sets over the years. So first deck on the left-hand side, we have Buffalo Charge by Dub Physics. Now I'll just play a little clip of this to you. Fast forward it a little bit. Now you'll hear there, it's not a lot going on in the track. It's quite stripped back, you know, there's like a heavy synth line in there, like a few bleeps, and then there's a kick and a snare and a little bit of hats in the background. Not much going on. There's quite a lot of space within that track. Now I'll play this one on the right, which is Tornado VIP by Vacuum. So you'll notice on both tracks, there's quite a lot of space within the tracks together. So if I like fast forward, you'll even see it on the waveform that there's quite a bit of space within the waveform itself. So there is gaps for other things to fit into. The same with this side here. If I zoom in, you'll see that there's spaces. So they're similar sort of tracks anyway. And a really important thing to notice here is both tracks are in the same key. They're both in 4A. So they're going to harmonically mix very well together anyway. Now, the next thing you need to really nail when it comes to this is your phrasing. Now, like I said in previous videos, you might have seen what phrasing is, and it's just basically getting those two drops to hit at the exact same time. So you need to know where you're setting your hot cues, when you're bringing the next track in, and where things switch in and out. It's just a really important thing that you need to really know about the tracks before you start mixing them together. So I've set a hot cue here on the left-hand deck. Hot cue C, which is exactly 64 beats before the drop. So I've done the exact same on the other side on hot cue C. It's exactly 64 beats before the drop. So if I play them both at the exact same time, I know that they're both going to hit the drop at the exact same time. So that's just one thing you need to really get nailed before, you know, you start mixing the two tracks and double dropping them. So give you an idea of how it sounds. Let's just jump straight in.
Buffalo charge and gargant, talk it again, go all in, stash to the garden, backyard, climb at the bar, breaking, can't stop, we are zoning, we have the intent, title, take with your crown and capture your land, take over, we deal with JG, tell it to sting it, you won't, can't get a grip, then head out in it. Buffalo charge and gargant, talk it again, go all in, stash to the garden, backyard, climb at the bar, breaking, can't stop.
I'm going to switch out the low end of Buffalo charge. Strip back. Together. So, like I say, it's all trial and error, seeing what you find works. Now, those two tracks just happen to work very, very well together. There is some tracks that you're going to mix together and think, they kind of work, they kind of don't. Some tracks will just fit just like that. Some tracks just will not work at all. So just go and have fun, experiment and try it out.
If you want to join an inclusive DJ community, then check out our DJ Hub. With hundreds of different tutorials, mix breakdowns, social media action plans and mini courses all inside. Take out the guesswork with our step-by-step learning platform and iOS app, so you can access your content anytime, any place. Just check out wearecrossfader.co.uk. Let's get back to the video.
Now for this next example, it's not exactly keeping both drops involved in the track, it's more switching it out, but keeping the tracks there still. So sounds a little bit confusing, but I'm gonna show you exactly what I mean. So on the left-hand side here, I have No Problem by Chasing Status, amazing track. And I'm gonna show you where I've set my hot cues and what I mean by I'm gonna keep both tracks going, but not the drops really. So I've got this track, set hot cue here. Just a drum loop that goes straight into this breakdown with the famous synth line. Now, what I want to do is when it gets to the drop of this song, I want to jump straight back to hot cue A because I know there, that's where the drums are kind of stripped back. There's not much going on. So I can switch this into another drop. So I'll show you now. I could keep it going and let it just go into the drop with the synth line. Just like that, but it's still got that synth over the top. And I don't really want that in this transition. You can keep it and it will still sound good, but I want this drop on the right-hand side to have more of an impact. So what I'm gonna do, when it gets to that drop, jump straight back to hot QA. Now, obviously that sounds really abrupt and it doesn't fit, but when you've got another track building up, it's gonna sound great. So again here, I got two tracks who are in the exact same key, so they're gonna harmonically fit again. So what we need to work out here is our phrasing again. The hot cues I've set, I've got B, which is again 64 beats before the drop. And then I've got a hot cue here on C, which again is 64 beats before the drop. So if I put these two together, what I'm gonna do is jump straight back to the hot cue A. This one's gonna drop in and they're gonna fit together so well. So have a listen. So yeah, it really works jumping back to that hot QA. If I left it going, here's what it would sound like. It wouldn't sound terrible, but not as clean. So yeah, like I say, it doesn't sound bad, but getting that back to the drum loop just adds more impact to the track on the right-hand side. So yeah, both tracks there were No Problem, Chasing Status, and Solar System by Sub Focus. Both in key, both great tracks. and they just work really well together. So for this last example, I'm going to show you another one that I've been doing in my sets over the years. Now, this one isn't drum and bass. Now, double drops, I know, are big in the drum and bass community, but like I say, you don't have to just put them in the box of they are drum and bass. They can be used in anything. So house, disco, hip hop, grime, whatever you want, as long as there's no vocals clashing over each other and it sounds messy, there's no rules. If it fits, it fits, and it's as simple as that. So you'll notice here I've got two tracks that are not in the same key, and you will understand why in a minute. The track on the right hand side, Hangover Casper remix. Now, this is an old dubstep tune, got an iconic vocal on it. Now, not a lot of harmonic content going on in that. You know, there's just that driving bass that's going up and down and that vocal that's going over the top. Now, on the left-hand side, I've got the famous tune by The Prodigy, Firestarter. Drop sounds like this. Now, there's not tons of harmonic content going on within this track on either side, really. So it doesn't really matter so much about being in key. I just know that I want to take the bass out of this tune on the right, just so I don't have the low end of this track. I want to keep it all in this side, and I'm just using the right hand deck for that vocal. So what I have here is a hook cue set, which is 32 beats before the drop. The same on the left hand side, hot QB is exactly 32 beats before the drop. You could go back further and do 64, but there isn't 64 beats on this track before it drops in. So for the sake of this, I've just done it at 32. So here's what they sound like together. I'm going to start with the Casper tune on hot QB. And then I know when it gets to C, that's my visual marker that I need to set off deck on the left hand side. So separately, together they just work so well. So I hope you've enjoyed this video and learned something new. Key things to take away from this are your mixing in key, unless you have tracks that don't have a lot of harmonic content, like the last example. Mixing in phrase, very, very important. But the most important, I can't stress this enough, is experimenting. Now, there are no rules with this. You know, you don't have to think that, oh, this can't work with that and this won't work with that. There's no rules with this. It's all down to just trial and error, experimenting and having fun. If it works, it works. Simple as that. The last thing I want to give you as an extra tip before this video ends is the importance of using your crates and playlists when it comes to double drops. So don't just leave it to yourself to remember all these double drops. It's all good having the double drops nailed. You might get really good at them. You might have a million, and that's all good. But just don't leave it to yourself to have to remember them. You know, use your crates for what they are there for. Set up a folder called double drops. Within there, get all the playlists going of the two tracks that work together. It might be two tracks, might be three, four, triple drops, quadruple drops, whatever. So really utilize those playlists and use them. They're so, so important to use. So yeah, hope you've enjoyed this video, and I hope to see you in another video sometime soon.